Hey, it's me, MLB. Here we are with Chapter 5 of Touched. This one's titled Smart and Hot. Being in hiding had worked perfectly up until now. "Will I have to run away, Dad?" you asked in a shaky voice. "I'm not sure, sweetheart, but don't worry," he said as he reached out and touched your hand. Peace washed over you and your worried expression faded. You knew that your dad had just used his quirk on you and you smiled. "He means well," you thought. The next day, as the workday came to a close, you prepared your reports and looked at the clock. "Okay, time to get these upstairs, then I can go." You stood up and walked to the door, peeking out. "I wonder if Hawks will come today. Wait, why am I thinking about Hawks? Do I like him coming to walk me to the boss's office? Well, yeah, I do, I guess. He's actually really sweet, on top of being hot." You looked out and down to the elevator as it started to come down to your level. Your heart started racing. "Is this Hawks?" you wondered. The numbers stopped moving and landed on your level, but the elevator doors didn't open, and you waited, watching intently while your heart pounded in your chest. Maybe it's an empty elevator. You slowly stepped out of your office and walked towards the elevator, your eyes trained on the doors. They still hadn't opened. You started to get excited. I think it might be empty. Oh my goodness, an empty elevator? You reached the doors and pressed up, and the doors dinged open, revealing a very smug Hawks leaning up against the inside wall of the elevator, like the chill hero he was. "Hey, chicken, you found me," he said in a flirtatious tone. You went the brightest shade of red that you'd ever gone in your life and made a squeaking noise. "Oh, sorry, did I scare the squeak out of you?" he chuckled softly. "Come on, I'm here to do my daily walk the cute shy girl to her boss's office." You just stared at him, not knowing what to do. "He just called me cute. He just called me cute. He just called me cute." You dropped your gaze and stepped inside the elevator, refusing to look at the sexy, smooth hero as his sharp eyes watched you. For the next 3 weeks, Hawks met you each afternoon for the walk to your boss's office, and each time you found it a little easier to talk to him, even if it was just a sentence or two. You had stopped hiding as well, which he seemed excited about. It was late on a Friday afternoon, and you were waiting for Hawks to meet you in your office. "Man, I'm hungry," you thought as you clutched your stomach. "That'll teach me for skipping lunch because there were too many people at the shop and I was too scared to go in amongst them and order." You hung your head and sighed as your stomach grumbled again. "Hungry, huh?" a voice said, and you looked up in surprise, coming face to face with Hawks as he leaned down on your desk. "Hawks," you squeaked, "when did you get here?" "What's your favourite food?" he asked, ignoring your question. You told him, "Hey, after you drop your reports to Mr. Ligma, I'll take you out to get that," Hawks said with a lopsided smile. "It's okay. It's a friendly gesture, not a date. I wouldn't push that on you," he said with a wink. "What do you say?" You waited up in your mind, looking at him for a bit as you thought. "Come on," Hawks sung as he continued to lean down on the desk casually. "What have you got to lose?" he asked with a cocky smile. "Oh, okay," you resigned softly. Hawks's face lit up. "You won't regret this," he said with a smile. "I know the best place in town to get it." "Okay," you replied with a small smile as he stood up. Hawks stepped back from the desk and waited for you to walk around beside him. "Let's go, chicken," he said with a flirtatious wink. You blushed again and looked down as the two of you headed out of the office and up to Mr. Ligma's room. After dropping off the reports, you and Hawks headed back down to your room to get your stuff, then you left. You felt a little nervous stepping out of the building beside him, and your steps faltered slightly. "Stay close, chicken," he uttered as he stretched his wings out, then tucked them in again. "Oh my God, it's Hawks!" someone screamed, and you jumped with fright as you hung your head. "No, this is so embarrassing. Everyone's going to look at us. I feel so uncomfortable," you thought, as the anxiety started to knot up in your stomach. Hawks noticed immediately and stepped forward and in front of you, one of his brilliant red feathers coming loose and floating in front of your face. You looked at it as it slowly rose up and your eyes followed it. As you raised your head, you caught Hawks glancing back at you. "Follow it," he whispered as he jerked his head in the direction of the feather. You looked to where it had floated off down the street and quickly followed after it, pulling your jacket up around your neck more to hide your face. You quickly glanced back at Hawks, who was happily taking pictures with his fans and chatting to them. "He did that to distract them so they wouldn't be looking at me," you thought with a grateful smile. You looked forward again and jogged a bit to catch up with the feather as it continued to float along. It led you down all kinds of roads and you wondered where it was taking you. Just then you heard the heavy flapping of wings and looked up to see Hawks descending from above. He tucked his gorgeous red wings in behind him and dropped down beside you. continuing to stroll as if he had been walking with you that whole time. Happens every day, he said casually, talking as if you two had been chatting for the past half hour. Sorry to throw you in the spotlight like that. He looked at you and his brilliant red feather returned to him. That's okay, he said quietly as he returned his gaze. Thank you for doing that. That was really kind. No sweat, he replied. You're a real shy one, huh? You nodded. Yeah. Always been like that? He asked as he strolled beside you with his hands in his pockets. Mm-hmm, you hummed in reply. Well, that's okay. I do a lot of talking each day, so it's nice to spend time with someone who isn't going to talk my ears off, he said with a chuckle. Far from it, he replied dryly. Oh-ho! He laughed with one eyebrow raised at you. A sense of humour too? Why does it feel like he's ticking off a list of qualities? Well, here we are, he said suddenly, taking his hand out of his pocket and gesturing to a building ahead. And don't worry, I've already thought ahead, he added as you approached the door. What does he mean by that? Hawks pushed the door open and ushered you inside before stepping in behind you. Hey! The guy at the door greeted with a giant smile. What's up, bro? He said, reaching his fist out to Hawks. Hey, man, how you doing? He said as he stepped past you and reached his fist out to the guy, bumping it against him before the two of them did an elaborate hand greeting. Just the two of you? The guy asked after he and Hawks had finished their aggressive sign language. And there ends chapter 5. Stay tuned for chapter 6.